Hello there, fellow summoners. Mad Dog HT here, and we're going into this is the last week of season 33 with Unstoppable Armor, and this is war number 11, and we were up against New Nation. I took 7 fights, kind of had them spread out throughout my team, and it was a pretty fun war, and this was a battle for potentially a number 3 spot. New Nation was in number 3, I think we were in number 5, and if we won this war, it would sit us pretty well, at least for the finish. If we didn't, then we have potentially some work to do in war number 12, the final war of the season. So here's a quick peek at the defense. The season ended, last week, but I'm just been able to get around to this. Been a little bit busy, but in any case, yeah, this is going to be a tough war. So New Nation's a really solid alliance. They banned Corvus, Hercules, and Ghost, which is a fairly standard ban. They didn't ban Quake, which is something that we don't mind at all. For me, I'm not gonna use Quake, but we have some guys that can Quake. For my assignment, I'm going up Path 2 and Path 3 in Section 2. And we got this Apocalypse on Node 5, Strike Counter Fury, Power Struggle. It's a rank 4 APOC, and I'm just going to go in with Thing, who is also rank 4. And just some pretty standard boosts. Power Start 1 doesn't do anything on this node. I could have applied a regen boost, but it's kind of redundant to what Thing can do for this fight. And invulnerability boost, not really concerned about that. So here I'm just starting out slow combos, kind of like medium, light, medium. I'm trying to get as many rock stacks as I can. I'm gonna let those Furies build up and just let Thing do his work. He's already got 9 plus of those passive Furies, so pretty much every single time he touches me, when I don't have protection up, it's gonna trigger protection. And pretty much the only thing that could really go wrong here is if I pushed him to special 2, if I pushed Apocalypse to special 2 and I somehow got hit with that and the concussion got applied, that can basically bypass Thing's protection. But otherwise, I'm just gonna block. Just do a block dex on the special one. I'm gonna try to bait the special ones. I'm not gonna even try to, get him to a special 2. If he did, I would just block everything and make sure that I did not get hit. But yeah, it's a pretty safe fight. It takes about 2 minutes with these boosts on. And, he was a little bit stingy at throwing specials at time, but nothing too crazy where I got backed up in the corner or anything like that. And I'm still just doing shorter combos to try to get as many parries in as possible so I can build up those rock stacks as quickly as possible. And right now we're at 59, and there we go, we're at 60. So now we're at max damage. And here we're gonna go start doing more full combos and after he throws his specials. And we can just let him build up his Furies. Yeah, so here he's being a little bit stingy, and we just go for it. I think we end up throwing the special 2, which is gonna stun him because we had 20 rock stacks. And we would have finished him off had that not killed him, but he was pretty low health anyway. So 72 hits, take down the rank 4 Apocalypse. And then next up we got Killmonger on node 14. So again, Strike Counter Fury, Brute Force, Power Focus 1. So we put White Magneto Guidance on this fight. We throw on some Mutant Boost. We are gonna just use White Magneto. We're gonna put a Power Start 1 boost on this fight just so that we can get him armor broke as quickly as possible. And then with the Power Start 1 boost, it kind of helps you to not have to worry as much about splitting up your combos between the medium, lights, and heavies. We're gonna get a heavy out the gate and get that long prowess. We are gonna be adjusting our combos. There we go, we throw off the special, and then pretty much we're just gonna spam special 1. I did put on the mutant power back boost. That was in case I did get to special 2, I could get some power back. But Yeah, every time we throw a special, we're going to get a heavy off to get the long prowess, and then we're just going to combo him and then throw the special one, keep getting that armor break, and we don't have to worry about the reverb. And yeah, it's a pretty simple fight for White Magneto. He's got a decent access to a fairly long armor break, and he just does a lot of good damage. I think one more special one will do it, and so it just took over, or not even over, just took about 1 minute to take that Killmonger out. So yeah, 37 hits, pretty simple and straightforward fight. And then next up, we were trying to decide who we were going to use for this Venom, and I was like, you know what, if you want me to take it with Thing, I'm 100% confident that I won't have any problems with taking it with Thing. So yeah, I got this assignment. We're going in. We still have that Power Star 1 boost on, which is not too relevant in this fight. Venom is an unstoppable armor champ, so I do have to worry or watch out about, one, the 10-second timer, and then every time that black symbiote Clintar buff cycles through, he could potentially get an armor up, so I'm going to watch out for that. But once he gets 7 buffs through that, he will not get any more, and as long as I don't let him throw a special 2 and convert all his buffs to Furies, he won't be able to get any extra armor up buffs, which is kind of nice. So we're just paying attention at the start of the fight, making sure that he's throwing special ones. We're paying attention to the global timer every 10 seconds. We make sure that he doesn't get the unstoppable, like right there. So we're just gonna back off. And here that Clintar is coming back up. Okay, so now he has an armor up. He has a Fury. 3 of the physical resistance, cruelty, and a precision. I think maybe the precision, I don't know if that's from a dex earlier, but he has max buff. So every time that Clintar buff cycles through, he will not get a new buff. So I don't have to worry about that anymore. All I have to worry about is his unstoppable armor timer. And right there, he was being kind of stingy, and then I just went in to like tap on the block, and then he threw a special. So we do get hit. We trigger backup recovery. Just barely doesn't get to special 2, which is good. And we're just gonna try to bait this out. We're getting backed up. He throws it finally, and then in this fight, we're just gonna close out this fight. Let's bait the specials and watch out for the unstoppable. Thing is immune to nullify, therefore power snack can't happen. Outlast, no big deal. Backup recovery, we've already taken care of that. So I think we just bait out this. I think we end it with a special. No, we just end it with a combo. Pretty solid option for that. Plus Thing is bleed immune, so if I, you know, if you do get hit, you won't get bled out, which is kind of nice. So next we're gonna move up into section 2. And we're going on path 32. So this one, I wasn't 100% certain on how the interaction was going to go. It's got the enhanced bleed, White Magneto's bleed immune, enhanced armor up, the Chitinous Thorns. Again, doesn't matter because Magneto is bleed immune, and then cutting wires. And he's not a robot, so I don't have to worry about the shock. So I do a regen boost just to kind of give some extra health. And I know, like, right at the beginning, he's got those 5 armor ups, 30% chance. Basically, he's going to start out unstoppable. And so we're just going to watch out for the 10-second unstoppable armor timer. Make sure he doesn't get another armor up. And then every time I push him over a bar or 2 bars of power, he's going to get another armor up. And we have to be careful with that. So my plan was to just throw a special 1. That would push him over 1 bar of power, and that hopefully would be enough, and then also heavy him. And you can see I got retaliated. You know, I hit him with the heavy, push him over a bar, but even with the stun, they become stun immune and can immediately retaliate. So I'm just gonna keep trying to use a special 1 to push him over and see if that won't be safe. And you're gonna see there, I thought that was gonna push him over. It wasn't quite enough. So here I just do one tap and then I back off. You didn't get the unstoppable armor from that. And I think it's maybe the next one or maybe the one after. You're gonna see we stun and then we throw the special. Nope, that is, I think maybe it's the next one where he gets an unstoppable armor on the special one and he's still able to counter and retaliate. And I think I take like a couple hit combo. But every special one I am able to armor break, so it's able to keep off some of Red Skull's armor. I think right here. No, maybe the next one. It's the next one. Kind of a long fight. I actually was planning originally to put the guidance on this fight to get the extra like pushback on the stuns, but I just spaced it. But it wasn't that big of a deal. I think it's on this next special. I think it's on this one right here. Yeah, he was able to counter that and then I get comboed. So, you know, had the RNG been worse with the unstoppable armor, I could have taken more hits and more damage and everything, but there we go. We got him down. And I don't run pacify, which could definitely help with regular stuns. But yeah, we get him down. And then last up, as far as the pass go, we have this iHulk. Of course, we have another iHulk that we get to fight. Seems like Immortal Hulk is always on my pass. I say that all the time just because it just seems like that's the case. Now, we didn't have any use for Torch's Nova Flame. And I applied the Flame on for this iHulk fight, which is, you know, seemed like overkill, but I just wasn't going to use it. We weren't going to use it anywhere else, so might as well get the extra speed and damage out of this one. And with Nova Flames on, this iHulk goes down quick. We're going to do some heavies at the beginning to build up our temperature. And it's got the best defense, which doesn't come into play. It's got enhanced armor up, doesn't come into play. Explosive personality. So that and heavy-handed, you know, if I hit into the block, he'll get some armor ups. We don't want that. If we get five armor ups, then they'll explode on us and we'll take major damage. So just don't hit into the block. And he's got five gamma. And I think he's going to throw a special here. Almost gone. And there we go. Five gamma. If you're under 15, it's a guaranteed kill without immortality, which is nice. And that went pretty quick and smooth. And then we're going to move up on to node 46. It's got the strike counter, combat power rate, chitinous thorns, buffet, and outlast. So I put on a health pot onto thing after I had gotten hit by Venom earlier. And, you know, the prior seasons when we didn't have unstoppable armor, we had, oh, I can't even remember what the global was called, but where you take the damage from them building up their charges and you just take blocked hits. Surfer was much more of a pain when you'd use somebody like Thing to counter, but here I don't have to worry about that. And my whole game plan here is normally I would bait out special ones, but I don't want this guy getting armor ups, just because Silver Surfer's armor ups are very, very potent, and they takes a lot to get past that armor, especially if you're just doing physical hits. So I'm just gonna keep pushing him to special twos and then let him throw that. And hopefully he doesn't throw any heavies to get any of the other buffs, but special twos are easy to get out of range. You can see I'm not throwing any specials in this fight. You might ask why. With the synergy with Thing and Torch, my Thing special one will put on an incinerate, and that's just gonna one heal Surfer, and it's gonna count as a buff towards, you know, being unblockable or getting the vigilance up if he throws a special one or a special two. So I'm just not gonna throw those. We're just going to basically ignore strike counter. We're going to just try to smash this guy down. We're immune to buffet, so he can't heal. We just got to get his original health down. And had I blocked a little bit more, I would have been able to build up his furies a little bit quicker, which probably would have been a better approach. But I was able to keep pushing him to special twos. He never threw one special one, which was nice. And we get him down in about a minute and 45, so not too long of a fight. And it was pretty simple. And then last up, my assignment on the island was to go over to the right side. Polka dot power, stunning reflection, stun vulnerability on node 53. We put on a guidance boost because we had the extra one that we didn't put on the Red Skull. And we go and we take off willpower masteries. This is going to cost us like 12 units total to take them off. Basically reapply all the other defensive masteries that cost gold. Come back in. We put on a invulnerability boost in case we get tagged. We do need to be watching, keep an eye out for the unstoppable armor, because Warlock is an unstoppable armor champ. He starts out with an armor up. Therefore, he could get a passive unstoppable at the beginning, and then every 10 seconds after that. So the one thing, the only tricky thing with this fight, I've taken this fight two other times this season, but you do need to watch out for infection not applying your, causing the application of your incinerates on your mediums or your light, your first light on torch. So here, he does get the unstoppable right out the gate, so we just block, wait that out, get a nice little intercept there, and then once we knock down that stun shield, the goal is to keep it down. And then right there, we did go in. Luckily, we didn't get tagged with the unstoppable armor coming in, but we want to parry as much as possible because we have that stun vulnerability, get a lot of damage off that, and we're going to try to bait out the special two. We do have infection on, so some of these hits, I believe, can cause it to where the incinerates don't apply. We'll probably see that in a second. And there, I just like whipped an attack and I get parried, use up the invulnerability boost. We're in the corner now. We're paying attention to that unstoppable armor and we're just being patient. Get a nice little draft back there. We're just going to block the special ones. That's going to build up our smolder, which is going to give us more damage. We're just waiting for a heavy. There we go. We retaliate. Disable the stun shield. A lot of unstoppable armors on this one. At least more than the other fights that I had taken. And here's another one. We're just going to block. Wait it out. Block in the corner. Get another little dash back intercept. And he goes down. So we get the solo, not the cleanest fight, but we got through it. So, and it was a good thing that we did use the invulnerability boost because that did save our bacon. We go and we throw on another WhMags on this man thing, and I will show that fight later on in the video, but then I go and take off my mastery. So again, taking off willpower and then adding it back on cost 12 units, so it's not too terrible. And then after we do that, 17, he takes down the man thing with Tigra, and then we just move up to the boss, which is the thing boss. I throw on my last white magneto guidance pre-fight for the extra attack on the boss. And then we're going to showcase our boss takedown. So 17, he's got Tigra with a kitty synergy. And Tigra is a great counter for Thing, especially when you have the skills to counter his specials and his heavies. And you're going to see that. So the neutralize will basically mitigate all of the times where he can like go unblockable and unstoppable, even when you're like pushing him at or around 15 rock stacks, think there is one time where he isn't able to keep the neutralize up, and he is able to get around it and hit into the block and get the hits that he needs to make sure that he doesn't go unstoppable and unblockable. But yeah, this is a rank 4 thing. So a lot of health, this class disadvantage. Now 17, he did have Mystic boosts on, but I don't have those showing as apply, just simply because Mystic boosts do not apply, or you don't get the benefit against class disadvantage. So when you're fighting science champs, it doesn't work. And that's for any class, any of the power back and special boosts, they don't work against class disadvantage champs. He also has all 3 Odin pre-fights on. And you might ask why. Well, he took path 8, and that helps to get through that path. So that's basically why he has those on. Not specifically for this fight, but the protection is the only thing that really can come into play and help him out. If he were to get hit, he would take less damage from it. But the other buffs aren't really there to do much of anything. So you can see he waits out that special. Guess the special 3 is gonna throw it to reactivate the senses and then just go back to town. And 17 does another great job at getting a solo on our bosses. I think he soloed 6 or 7 of our bosses this season. Did a really good job with Tigra. There uses invulnerability boost. That's why you put it on there, in case you slip up a little bit. But yeah, the damage, so like right now you can see he's at 40%. Let's see how much this special 2 gets him down to. That's about 20% special. Not too bad. All of those ruptures just ticking away, and I think he's gonna finish with maybe another special 2 and then maybe a special 1. Yeah, I think he's gonna get it off one more heavy. No, no, just the heavy and finish him off. So pretty solid job there. As far as our battle group goes, we did die 3 times. They died once. So they did best us there. And as an alliance, we died 8 times, which isn't terrible, but it's not great. But New Nation, they only died twice. So really solid job to them. They got the win. We took the loss. Which was unfortunate, but you know, we did the best we could. And as far as my stats go, 7 fights, 7 kills, no deaths. On the season, I have 68 fights, 68 kills, 2 deaths. And with that loss, we dropped to 7-4 on the season with 1 war left. We dropped 2 spots in Masters to number 7 overall. So we're still in the top 10. And after looking at the leaderboard and the top 12, or not the top 12, the war 12 matchups, we actually pretty much locked in the top 10 spot. Like, as long as we finish the map and we don't have like an insane amount of deaths, we pretty much locked in the top 10. But we are going to give it our all in the last war of the season, because we want to go out fighting. And yeah, we're just gonna do our best. And then here's the items for the war. A couple 20% boosts, couple attack and health boosts. I had to boost 3 times. As far as gray boosts, we had 1 of each used. Only 1 health potion used, 12 units total for some mastery swap to drop the willpower mastery. And we got 355 units used in the season. Tons of boosts all across the board. Man, you look at that, all those boosts, it looks kind of crazy. But and then here's my little collage of all my champs used and champs defeated. We added 2 fights to Torch, he's up to 22, 3 to Thing, he's up to 25, and then 2 more for White Magneto. The White Magneto fights went pretty well. I like using him. He is a underrated attacker for sure. And then, yeah, so here, let's showcase some of my team's fights. So this was the node 55, the best defense, hard knock life, brute force, and limber node. It's got a rank 4 man thing. This is 17 again. This This is right before he took down the boss. And this, I put on the white Magneto pre-fight for him. He's got Mystic Boost on with a Power Start 1. And I think in that graphic, yeah, I messed up on that graphic. It has an invulnerability boost, but he did a Power Start 1. And he's just going to try to counter his heavy with her heavy. Got a little sketchy there on the spacing on that. This one will connect. And then he's going to launch the special 2. Tons of ruptures, tons of damage. Got the power back coming. He got just over a bar back on that. He's got a beta special. He is going to be getting some armor breaks and some poisons on this fight, but Tiger does just nuke it down. Does a great job there countering the special 1 with the miss. Another special 2. Lights out. Great job there, 17. And then here is a fun fight. This is on path 9. It's this Wearim. He's using his Penny Parker. This is the Hazard Shift, Incinerate Poison, Feat of Indestructible 1, and Power Focus 1. And he starts with a Power Start 1. Kind of gets a little bit lucky there with the Unstoppable. A little bit too many hits to push him over to go Berserk. And now he's just going to wait out most of this Berserk phase, and then he's gonna get to the special 2 and just light him up. And you're gonna see the crazy damage that Penny can do. Got 12 charges, boom. Unfortunately, she's not awakened, so she can't get the heal blocks, but those incinerates just nuke him down. One special 2, pretty cool fight. And then Wearim's got another one here. This is a very interesting matchup. This is Nimrod on node 25 going up the middle. He's an unstoppable armor champ, so you have to be aware of that. This has got Footloose, Force of Will, Crumbling Armor, and Kinetic Transference. So Footloose, Spider-Gwen is a great counter because she has this access to the slow on the heavy. And when Nimrod does go into Eradicate Protocol, he has unblockable specials, which you'll see Wearim taking great advantage of with Spider-Gwen. So the cool thing with Spider-Gwen is when you pair her up with Penny Parker, she starts out with all 5 charges, and she can basically totally bypass the unblockable specials. She's got the enervate on the special 1 to get the power lock to help control how many specials this guy does. You know, kinetic will still apply. So here we go. He throws a whiff into that special and then just doesn't block, so that he can just totally bypass and auto evade the unblockable special, which is really cool. Just try his best to keep the slow up and then bait those specials. And Spider-Gwen, she hits really, really hard with 5 charges. So you don't think that this would be a typical matchup, but we do a lot of maybe what you would call like non-standard matchups. But we have a lot of fun in how we plan and, you know, tackle our maps. Spider-Gwen destroys this rank 4 Nimrod. It's not like the fastest fight by any means, but it's very safe, and she counters him well. So right here, again, unblockable. It doesn't have to do anything. It just auto-evades it, which is pretty awesome. Again, unblockable, auto-evade it, and just going to town. A lot of draft pack intercepts, got that enervate up to where he can't gain any power. He does gain power from the kinetic transference, so do have to be mindful of that. But Spider-Gwen doing her thing. We've actually used Spider-Gwen quite a bit. She also is a Defiance champ, so she's gonna have some solid work put in for the next 2 seasons when we have the Mystic Dispersion tactic in play. Here he goes, unblockable, auto evade. Super nice. Again, unblockable, auto evade. And 4% left. And she's at full health. Mainly because of the crumbling armor. And, you know, when you throw specials and stuff, you get the willpower healing from Nimrod's debuffs that you get applied to you. And then we're going to show pass 6. So this is Boom going in with his rank 4 Nimrod. So we have the Storm on node 28. Now Storm is, this is after her buff. So she is immune to shocks, but with Omega Sentinel on the team, if they are immune to the shocks, instead you apply Incinerate. So you can get some pretty solid damage off on the Storm while still being able to get rid of all the prowess and preventing the prowess with either the Cowardice or being in Eradicate or Blitz protocol. And those Incinerates just absolutely melt Storm, so it's a pretty cool option to use there. Boom did a great job. And then just one more Nimrod fight. He's gonna apply WhMags to this Kraven. This is on node 38. It's got the Hard Knock life. And Nimrod, you know, even though Kraven is not a mutant, you know, Nimrod still puts in a lot of good work against non-mutant champions, and this just showcases that. And this, you know, pretty much same goal and game plan here is just to get to special 2 and nuke down with the shock damage. Still going to be really solid. Boom is going to parry quite a bit still, even with the disorients. You can see that it doesn't come into play a ton. It will prevent some of the stuns from happening, but it's not that big of a deal. Does have to watch out for the traps that he sets from the special one. And I think right here, yeah, gets the shocks and the blitz and takes off about half of his health. And he's going to build up and get back to special 2 once more. And that will be it for this Kraven. So Nimrod, I can't wait to get my Nimrod ranked up to rank 4. He's next on my list. So there, takes out the Kraven. And then last fight, this one was a fun one. We were debating on like who to use, and we're like, you know what, we think that Venom Pool will be the best option. And McLeod 33, he brought in his Venom Pool specifically for this fight only. And it's got combat deja vu, so you want to try as much as possible to prevent those prowess and the puncture prowess from being activated, particularly when, you know, she's going to throw specials, because it can be pretty brutal. But her special one, you know, you're not going to be blocking that. It's just baiting the special two. So really, you just don't want the puncture prowess and combat deja vu to come into play when she potentially has 2 bars plus a power, because that would hurt. But this is just bait special ones. Venom Pool cannot be power drained. He can be auto blocked, but he can't be drained. And you're going to see him get auto blocked here and there. And then the whole goal is to build up to special 3 and then get off the conflictor. So parry, get the power gain activated, and then throw a heavy into a special 3 to get the big bleed off so that it will stick, because you've already just parried. And then get that bleed paused, because you got your cooking meter. Once it hits 100, it will pause. And yeah, it's not the quickest fight by any means, but very, very safe. And Venom Pool just will rinse this Penny Parker once he gets to special 3. Takes a bit to get there, but he will bait the heavy. Here we go. We're at 2 bars now, and I'm not certain if McLeod probably used an invuln boost for safety. Maybe it would have been nice to get the power start one, but also the extra bar power that has to be gained will build up all the buffs that he has, so he'll make him have more furies and whatnot, and make that special 3 bleed more potent. So he's just about there. He's got 5 furies. Alright, so now he needs to get there. He throws off. Ah, see, he didn't get the vicious off, which would have helped, but not the biggest deal. So he triggers a conflictor. He's gonna get the bleed to stick on the special 3. And you can see that bleed's going for 3,400 a tick. Just gonna block all that. And got it paused. And she bleeds out. So that's all for the war. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.